Welcome children. Today I am going to explain about future perfect tense. Before starting the future perfect tense, let me tell you that in my previous class I have already explained about simple future and future continuous tense. And now I am going to explain about future perfect tense. Future perfect tense denotes that the action will be completed in the future before another future action takes place. That means the verb expressing the future action is put into the future perfect tense and the verbs expressing the subsequent action is put into the future perfect tense. For example, I shall have written my letter before he comes. This sentence shows that my action of writing a letter will be completed in the future before another future action of his coming takes place. Now, let me give you the rules of future perfect tense. Rule 1. In case of future perfect tense, if the sentence is given in positive form, then shall or will plus have plus third form of the verb is added. For example, number 1, he will have prepared his speech by Tuesday. Number 2, the baby will have gone to sleep by evening. Rule 2, in case of future perfect tense, if the sentence is given in negative form, then will plus not plus have plus third form of the verb is added. For example, number 1, I will not have gone to bed by then. Number 2, you will not have completed your revision by then. Rule 3, in case of future perfect tense, if the sentence is given in question form or interrogative form, then shall or will plus subject plus have plus third form of the verb is added, or question word plus shall or will plus subject plus have plus third form of the verb is added. For example, number 1, will I have gone to bed by then? Number 2, we will have shopped non-stop for the party. Other examples. Number 1, when will the president have addressed the nation? Number 2, what will Vincent have arranged for the venue? Now, let me give you where do we use future perfect tense. Number 1, to express an action that will be completed before a certain time in future. For example, they will have finished serving the food by the time you reach the restaurant. This sentence shows that the action of serving the food will be completed before a certain time you reach the restaurant in future. Number 2, to mark a duration in future. For example, they will have stayed in Delhi for 10 years. This sentence shows that their staying in Delhi for 10 years marks a duration about future. Number 3, to talk about a past in a certain or sure way. For example, the train will have arrived by now. This sentence shows that the train's arrival is a past action and is talked in a way of surety or certainty. Number 4, to express an action completed before a given moment in the future. For example, when you reach home, your father will already have left for office. This sentence shows that his father's action of leaving for office will be completed before a given moment of his action. He is reaching home. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.